she would divorce him. And then she marries a man who I thought he had...
Was a boyfriend before.
He was a boyfriend long before. He liked her very much. But she always loved Leslie. And it's not till the very end of the book that there's a reconciliation of sorts, and I don't want to give the story away, but it is a very bittersweet ending in the story. Now, there was another man in the story who intrigued me, and I don't know how to pronounce his name.
Ziga.
And this young man actually swam the Danube River.
I mean,
we're not talking summertime and nice balmy breezes. It was cold. Was frigid, and it takes a lot of strength to do that. But he did that in order to reach freedom.
Yes.
So, Annamaria, how awful was it in Romania that people would risk so much to leave?
Zita, that is a very wonderful question. And when we decide to come, a lot of people don't know here that freedom means talk against the system. That's what we don't have. The freedom is for religion. Like here we have a free Christmas or whatever religious holiday, we have people free. We never, none of the religion was free. Yes, we had churches, but you know, people would like to more. And we hear from Western countries like, oh, Christmas or Easter or, you know, you was free, and we never. So we want to talk against the system if we said we don't like it. Mm-hmm. We want to have free holidays, religious holidays. And if we had money, we would like to go see other countries. And again, we couldn't. Very few times you. So that was what we did not have. But us to know, that was it. You have to go, how they saying here, to leave both sides of the fences.
Yes.
Now, we came here, and everything is wonderful because you have everything and behind everything. You really, if you work and everybody's pocketbook, the stores, and you can say whatever you say. If you have money, you can go. But sometimes it's making me sad one thing. Because people don't know the other side of fence.
Very true.
And they don't appreciate what they have.
I'd agree with you.
They don't know what they have. Now me, I understand, because back there, we didn't know what was the drug, what was the guns on the street. We didn't know this thing. We was free or kids playing on the street. We didn't know then.
Well, so that's interesting. It's almost like life was so controlled that it was safer.
It was so much, that's the right word, Zita. It was safer. But you don't know till you're not living. And I feel if people would know what is normal humanly and appreciate what we have, then you would not think or ask sometimes what I'm seeing in TV and I'm seeing people complaining for what? For not too much. You would appreciate the family life and all the, you know what, the plain English, too much freedom to the wrong reasons.
For the wrong reasons. That's very, very interesting because I think you would find a lot of people who would agree with you. And I think what I find so valuable about fiction is that you can take the thoughts you have, you can take the, you know, talking about the themes of freedom and trust, and certainly in this book there was some stubbornness, you know, Julie was a very stubborn young woman, the whole idea of the theme of regrets, and the you know, one of my favorites, because I'm a romance writer, the idea that love, you know, can span not only decades but continents, and you can take those very real themes that you lived in your life, and you know of people whose lives echoed these very big themes in real life, and put it in fiction. So people can get a glimpse of what that was all like in an entertaining fashion, which I think is the whole beauty of of fiction, but you certainly left you left a lot behind that I think for some people in this country would say, well, you left safety, and there is something to be said for that. But I wouldn't trade.
I can say I be not regretting, and no. Don't get me wrong, like I'm putting everything down here now. And I understand if you never was exposed besides nothing what we have here. I understand people, you don't know.
No.
You don't know how we didn't know. So it's never a happy medium, but our life individually, like we are, and since we are here, we saw a few country, and I can talk now. I understand. I mean, I get to that point. Doesn't matter. I talk or not. Doesn't matter anymore. But I'm enjoying the life. I'm enjoying this freedom, and I don't know. It's just so beautiful, and I wish the people to understand what they have.
Well,
here.
I think when people read your book, I think they will understand because, as I said, it's the beauty of fiction, that you see a truth told in a story. Okay. I want to ask you a little bit about the writing of the story itself, because I think that was a fascinating story. Now, I know English is not a second language for you. I think it's a third,
yes,
third
a
language.
Third, yes.
And you're learning several other languages.
Yes.
Let me ask you another question before that. This book.
Yes.
I know from correspondence that we had before the show that you don't use a typewriter, you don't use a computer.
I can't.
How did you write the book?
I wrote the book by hand and Hungarian in my language. Then I had to go back home to Romania and I find somebody who was typing, because in today's world nobody's working with your handwriting. So I find a person who was typing. Then I had to find another person who was translating. And it's amazingly, because how I wrote my book, just between my customers, I never could do home. Just between my customers, I never read back. I wrote a page or two, but I never sit down and read back. I just made a continuation. And when they translated and when they typed, the lady, they told me like, oh, you had some mistakes. I said, I was in Romania back home 2 weeks, like you have to do whatever, then we'll see. So 1 year took them and I get the translated through my son's computer. Then I realized I am back to the page one. Now I need another help. Now it's amazing because my face, I never a complainer. So my customers, I have a lot of customers for many years, they know my facial expression. I say, Anna, is something wrong? Oh, it's nothing wrong. Yes, it's something. So I said, oh, look at that. I get back the translation and it's not good. And now I don't know. Okay, you know, Anna, I'm going to try to do this. Then my daughter-in-laws, I try to fix the English in Hungarian. So I needed that to translate it.
So you started writing it in Hungarian. Someone had to type it. Then it had to be translated to English. Mm-hmm. And in the writing of it on paper by hand, you're doing this in between customers. You're a manicurist. You have your own Wethersfield. So you're in Rocky Hill.
Yes.
Okay, so you're doing this in between customers. How long did it take you to do this, to finish this book?
Actually, the original, I did in 1 year and a half, because it's not a big book. The rest took me like around 11 years.
11 years?
I mean, not the rest. Altogether, I'm sorry. Altogether took me like 11 years, because then I have to find somebody else. When I fix the Hungarian, then that needed to be typed back again. Then somebody, three people helped me, then they all put in the disk. Then I needed it to be put in one disk. Then whatever the three disks could not be put together, then again then somebody, like, because I believe in destiny, I believe in something, and always was my face told me something in front of the right person.